The Starship, SpaceX's under-development giant rocket designed to send people to Mars, can also be set to send people around the planet in under an hour. Now it's no secret that SpaceX, as well as founder Elon Musk, want to develop floating spaceports which will provide launch sites for the company's super heavy class launch vehicles. SpaceX will use these larger rockets to get its forthcoming large payload rocket Starship to the Moon and Mars, as well as point-to-point travel around the Earth. Nevertheless, plans to actually develop marine launch platforms seemingly lacked teeth for a long time. That is, until June, when SpaceX posted two jobs for engineers who will assist design and build an operational offshore rocket launch facility. Neither posting mentions about Starship, but both are located in Brownsville. The Brownsville city in Texas sits approximately 30 minutes west of the state's southeastern tip. That is exactly where SpaceX is building and testing Starship rocket prototypes, amid Boca Chica Village, a community of retiree-age homeowners. The company has been expanding its testing and development site in the area, and has also sought to increase the resources dedicated to its operations in the state. In this video, we will discuss why SpaceX wants to build an offshore spaceport near Texas for Starship rocket. Let's get into details. On Tuesday, 16 June, CEO Elon Musk answered to a report about a SpaceX job listing. The post, spotted by a Twitter user named Cowboy Dan Posh, is an opening for an offshore operations engineer. This engineer will work with a team to design and build an operational offshore rocket launch facility. Musk responded to the post by writing that SpaceX is building floating, super heavy class spaceports for Mars, Moon and hypersonic travel around Earth. To realize that ambition, SpaceX will have to find a way to efficiently pack propellant, fueling, and pressurization systems, a potentially skyscraper-sized launch tower and crane, one or two landing pads and a launch mount, crew quarters, propulsion, major power supplies, and much, much more onto a very large ship. Even though the post is exciting news itself, Musk also suggested on Twitter that these inter-Earth flights could start taking off relatively soon. But, it's not very clear if the floating spaceports Musk is proposing would be fixed or perhaps in case, they'd follow in the much smaller footsteps of SpaceX's current booster recovery drone ships. The developments suggest SpaceX's plan for inter-Earth travel is a key aspect of the plans for Starship. The SpaceX Starship rocket was first unveiled under the title BFR by Musk in September 2017, in which he updated the world on SpaceX's plans to build cities on Mars and populate them with a million people or even more. Musk detailed plans for inter-Earth travel at exactly the same event, which could enable passenger to get around the world in under an hour. A flight from Los Angeles to New York, that would usually take 5 hours and 25 minutes would have only 25 minutes with the SpaceX Starship. London to Hong Kong, a ride that typically takes 11 hours 50 minutes, would have only 34 minutes. During the presentation, Musk shared the video recording of SpaceX Starship rocketing passengers from an ocean platform near New York City. Consequently, landing them later on a similar floating spaceport near Shanghai. Musk named the high-speed transportation concept Earth to Earth. Depending on concepts published by the company in 2017, it can be determined that SpaceX Starship's floating launch facilities will probably gauge a minimum of 300 meters, 1,000 feet, long and about 100 meters, 300 feet, wide and displace numerous tens of a large number of tons. For reference, these kinds of a platform will be a lot more compared to 10 times bigger than SpaceX's football field-sized drone ships and considerably bigger compared to the common American city block. It will be real, Musk wrote. The concept of ocean platform launches is not new. An organization called Sea Launch, for example, first launched an orbital-class Zenyit rocket from a platform in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean in March 1999. Though SpaceX lacks operational experience launching rockets from ocean platforms, it has landed more than 4 dozen first-stage rocket boosters, the most expensive part of a launch system, given the numerous complex engines attached to their base, and landing them on drone ships. The boosters are then refurbished and reused, saving SpaceX millions of dollars per use and allowing the company to be price competitive. When a Twitter user brought up Sea Launch and its Zenyit rocket, Musk responded, "Zenyit is an order of magnitude smaller than Starship system and doesn't come back and land." Now it seems SpaceX is ready to make the leap, with safety as a driving factor. Homeowners who attended a private meeting with Musk in September 2019 told Business Insider that the entrepreneur described long-term plans to move away from land-based launch pads and instead use offshore platforms near Boca Chica Beach to fly Starship with less risk to the ground. Starship is divided into two sections, the first stage Super Heavy Booster, which may stand about 22 stories tall, and the upper stage rocket ship called Starship, which Musk said could ferry up to 100 people to Mars at a time. A fully stacked Starship Super Heavy vehicle could weigh more than 9 million pounds, mostly in fuel, and each section returning to Earth would create deafening sonic booms, perhaps 3 times per day per rocket, or 1,000 launches per year. "We need to be far enough away so as not to bother heavily populated areas. The launch and landing are not subtle. But you could get within a few miles of the spaceport in a boat," Musk tweeted on June, adding that a jet-powered in-cat ship may be suitable for land-to-platform transportation.